Chapter 4 is the most challenging chapter in our study of fluid mechanics. And this is because we stop looking at cases where we know what the flow is before our eyes in that outlet type of analysis. But instead, we want to predict what is going to happen in the future as a fluid flows through a certain control volume. We want to do this with pen and paper when we can, and certainly in general with computers. In our sub-discipline called computational fluid dynamics, or CFD. Now, there are two tasks that you could work on as you prepare for Chapter 4. In the first part of Chapter 4, we'll deal a lot with Newton's second law. Newton's second law just says mass times acceleration is the sum of forces. And we're going to apply this to a fluid particle, and so the law becomes mass of the particle times its change in time or velocity is equal to the net force due to pressure, shear, and gravity. The good news is we dealt with pressure and shear quite a lot so far. And so a good task for you would be to recap all of this and try to write Newton's second law as it applies to a fluid particle based on the things we study in chapter 1 and chapter 2. This is going to be a vector equation. So it's going to have three components in x, y, z. And so try to split the equation up into three components, x, y, z. See what it looks like overall, three scalar equations. Another big hurdle that we have to face in chapter 4 is dealing with a lot of information at once. This is because the acceleration of a certain particle, fluid particle, depends very strongly on what its neighbors are doing, front and back, and left and right, and top and bottom. And so if we say we want to solve where that particle is going, it's very useful to have information about its neighbors as it flows along. Imagine now that you have 1,000 particles going through a certain volume, and you want to record, you want to predict the trajectory of each of those particles, so their position, for example, x, y, z, then you need to solve a system of 3,000 equations with 3,000 unknowns. And so this is quite difficult, especially when the movement is chaotic and changes at every second. The way we best deal with this is by not following a certain particle or any group of particles as it flows along. But instead, what we do is we split up the control volume with a grid. And we're going to solve for the change in velocity of the fluid at every point inside the grid without following what the fluid is going. So we want to be able to predict at a certain point how the velocity of passing particles is changing in time. To do this, we're going to use what we call the Eulerian point of view on the fluid, which is the point of view where you stand next to the river. You stick your instruments into the river and you measure how the fluid properties are changing in time. Preparation task to think about this, to manipulate this a little bit, will be to think of the following problem. Imagine that there's a pipe, a simple pipe going from this side to that side with water flowing inside. And the flow is very steady, very smooth, and you stick a temperature probe inside the pipe. Now imagine that the temperature of the fluid is not uniform. That is, the flow which is upstream is very much hotter than the flow downstream. And so when the water flows, you're going to measure an increase in temperature with your probe. Question is, how does the temperature change in time at the probe? How can I express this? What information do I need to know about the fluid to be able to predict how fast temperature at this probe is changing due solely to the fact that temperature is not uniform inside the pipe? Once we manipulate this way of thinking about the flow as from the point of view of a fixed probe, instead of flowing with the particles, we'll be able to write up a system of equations that we'll have trouble solving by hand, but that hopefully we can solve with computers. That is the base of CFD, subdiscipline of fluid mechanics. So these are the two questions you could think about as you prepare for chapter 4. One is, what does Newton's second law look like when I apply it to a fluid particle, and especially in three components? And second, how do I predict the change in time of property locally when the flow is non-uniform? I wish you a very happy preparation, and I'll see you on Thursday for the next lecture.